I was 19 years old, and one night I get a sharp pain in my chest. I fall to the ground, and I can hear this voice. You're sick, dying, and if you don't do something about it, you're going to die. The next day, I'm in my family practitioner's office, Dr. Martin. Nothing is wrong with you, Christina. Your heart is fine. Your lungs are fine. The chest pain you have is acid reflux. Take this medication, it will help you. Dr. Martin, I still have the pain. Something is seriously wrong with me. I don't have acid reflux. My boyfriend at the time, Alessandro, had mentioned to me, Kri, baby, why haven't any of the doctors ordered a CAT scan? Call the police, Dr. Martin, because I'm not leaving your office without a CAT scan. An hour later, Dr. Martin and I are negotiating, and we negotiated down to an ultrasound and an upper GI. 2 days later, I'm in a hospital across town about to start the upper GI, and a nurse runs in. Dr. Martin called, we need a CAT scan, Christina, immediately. 3 hours later, Dr. Martin called my parents to say, Christina has pancreatic cancer and 6 months to live. 3 weeks later, I become one of the youngest pancreatic cancer survivors in the world. I had a Whipple surgery, which entails the removal of 5 of my organs, completely or partially. I was in the hospital for another 3 weeks, and then I was released with a 13-inch scar across my body. And I thought the hardest part was over. I was in the cutest relationship at the time with Alessandro. I mean, the cutest relationship you can possibly be in at 20 years old. It was pretty difficult for him to watch me face cancer. And he thought the best way of never losing me again was to get married. I'm now 20, having an identity crisis, and I was like, oh, no, not right now. He got upset and scared, and he said, but Kri, you have to marry me. Who's gonna love you now that you have a 13-inch scar across your body? Now, before you judge him for what he said, hear me out.